use our local currency on a daily basis to make essential purchases. But why do these notes we use have value? On a standard £5 note, you can see at the top the name of the central bank that has issued the note. Below this, you can see a promise. I promise to pay the bearer on demand the sum of £5. Without this statement, it is simply just a piece of paper. The term fiat derives from the Latin saying, it shall be. The currencies we all use, be it euros, dollars, maybe even yen, have no intrinsic material value. However, in the eyes of our governments and central banks, it shall be worth the value printed on paper. Decred, as well as other cryptocurrencies, are developing a disruptive new monetary system. If you are yet to watch the introduction to Decred, I would highly recommend watching this before proceeding with any lessons. At the start of this tutorial, I'll be exchanging my fiat currency to Bitcoin and Ethereum. Decred is currently most accessible through other cryptocurrencies. I'll be using two different methods of obtaining Decred via more easily obtainable currencies. When you go to a foreign exchange, you're usually asked for a government-issued photo ID. This is to prevent money laundering, and the same policies affect the crypto space. It's called Know Your Customer. When you sign up to a crypto exchange service, you'll have to go through a number of checks in order to create an account. The more information you give, the higher your limits. Some exchanges raise limits on a usage basis, so don't be surprised if your first deposit is a nominal amount. In this demonstration, I used crypto exchange Coinbase to exchange my British pounds to Bitcoin and Ethereum. Setting up a crypto exchange account is a relatively easy process. For the sake of this demonstration, I'm going to skip this process. Here are road forks. You can either manually trade Decred, or you can use a crypto exchange service to deposit it into your wallet of choice. Given this is an introductory lesson, I'm under the impression that many of the people watching this probably don't have a Decred wallet set up. With this in mind, I'll be using the on-exchange wallets for this lesson. Exchanges can be insecure and vulnerable to attacks, so in future lessons I'll be looking at local solutions to store Decred. Until then though, I have some Ethereum and some Bitcoin to exchange. For the next step, I'll need an exchange that supports Decred. In this demonstration, I'll be using Bittrex. Later in this tutorial, I'll be using a crypto exchange service called Shapeshift to exchange Ethereum to Decred. Other exchanges are available. You can use a number of websites to find exchanges that support Decred. Now I'm going to deposit the Bitcoin into the exchange wallet. Take care when depositing any funds. Crypto transactions are irreversible. Failure to verify addresses could result in loss of funds. Crypto transactions require confirmations on the blockchain. Bitcoin transactions require 6 confirmations. Transactions are displayed as pending until this number is met. At this point, funds are not spendable. Block explorers can be used to track confirmations on crypto transactions. Bittrex allows funds to be spent after only 2 transactions. These transactions have been confirmed on the blockchain. We can find Decred in the exchange by typing DCR into the market search bar. we are greeted with a candlestick graph. Reminder, this is not a trading tutorial, and any action taken within this window is done so at your own risk. At this point, I'm going to put in an order at the rate of the last executed trade. I receive notifications that my trade has been filed. I can now see the Decred sits in my exchange wallet. With the Bitcoin exchange, now it's time to exchange over the Ethereum. As previously mentioned, we'll be using Shapeshift in order to make this exchange. The process of exchanging using Shapeshift is extremely simplified in comparison to using an exchange like Bittrex. You wouldn't use an online trading platform in order to get foreign currency to go on holiday, for example. So why would you do the same in the crypto space? Shapeshift does away with all the charts and the buying options. All you need is an input address and the output address in your chosen currency. Using a QR scanner or copying from clipboard can mitigate any human error whilst inputting addresses. Once again, make sure to verify before sending any funds. At this point, it's also worth noting that the original Bitcoin to Decred transaction could have been also handled in Shapeshift. In Shapeshift, the exchange has been completed. I can see the transaction on the mainnet Block Explorer. I cover the Block Explorer in more detail in a later lesson. In Bittrex, my deposit is still pending confirmations. Once I have 6 confirmations, I can then send these funds elsewhere. This marks the end of this lesson. In this lesson, I've introduced you to the fundamentals of exchanging fiat to cryptocurrencies. Using Bitcoin, I've also demonstrated an exchange between Bitcoin and Decred using Bittrex Exchange. As well as this, I've also shown an alternative method using Shapeshift.io in an exchange between Ethereum and Decred. In the following lessons, I'll be having a look at setting up Decred's local wallets. If you have any questions, drop them in the comment section below. If you would like further updates, hit subscribe. On a final note, I'm Kyle, and I look forward to seeing you in the next lesson.